is considered to be a hyperextension. So as this gentleman comes in with a punch, let's say, and we block it here, we're not just going to try to take him down. We are going to roll this over on this nerve at the tricep, this way. We're also going to palm this. This is secondary. You don't have to do this, but it's going to stack these techniques nicely. Now the question is, how do you take them down from here? A lot of people want to drive them straight down, but that doesn't usually work out. When he steps up with that foot, now he can brace himself, and if he doesn't have a lot of nerves, I'm stuck. So there are two ways to do this. You drive him through the hole. That's one way. The other is to drive him off of the little toe. So if we drive him through the hole, we're going to swing him. And then we'll put him down here in this gooseneck. The other is to drive him toward the little toe. So as he's here, we drive him that way. This keeps him belly down. All right? And we still have this nice gooseneck. All right? Now, Shihanage. If we do grasp the bird's tail with a punch, then we take this, and we want to hit this pressure point right here that'll make him spin. But don't rely on the pressure point. You also want to hit this elbow, kind of with your elbow down and this way. Get this arm away from you. Then turn. Now, this is normal elbow up, nice, but we go play off of an angle so that it engages the shoulder. The shoulder is very much engaged in a chicken wing right now. When I drop him on his side, but if you'll notice, I've moved my hand down to right here, and I'm going to take this, I'm going to turn it this way, because this is a wrist technique, and I'm going to engage the shoulder at the same time, that way. Chicken wing, wrist technique, slowly. Shihanage, play it at an angle, not straight away. Now, we also have figure fours. We want to come up, try to not let him break the plane of his front. So if he's over his nose, he starts to gain momentum very quickly. You want to come up with this. All right, there's also a throw, because if you look at your Aikido, this is a throw, this is a throw, and you're just going back, perturbing the back, perturbing the spine. So if you walk through, you throw it. If you push up, figure four, and again, play at an angle. Now, see my hand slip down? Now I've got two techniques at one time. Very good. Now, the same thing works with a kick. If he kicks this way, and I drop him, I can figure four this with my body. Step down, keep this angle, keep it deep. And now I am putting a lot of pressure on his knee. If I lean forward, really, really hurts. I'm on a couple of pressure points. While we've got him down here, we'll figure four the ankle. It's done the same way, but I'm going to play off the big toe. So as I engage the Achilles tendon, I play the big toe forward. So that's figure four there also. When there's a joint, there's usually a figure four.